Welcome to Electron Line. So what is the material made out of that's in between the stars, known as the interstellar medium? And we also, and I don't know if you can see it there, we call it the ISM, the interstellar medium. Well, if we take a look at this picture, here you can see between the stars, and I don't know if you can see it with the camera, but if you take a look at this picture, there's just an incredible number of stars. Essentially, what we're doing is we're looking towards the center of our own galaxy. And you can see there's plenty of nebulas all throughout that blocks the light coming from many stars that are there as well, but you just can't see it because the nebulas are kind of covering it up. But you can see, when you look at some of the more clear parts of the picture, there's just an incredible number of stars throughout the galaxy. Yes, there's about 250 billion stars, and that's just a small portion of the entire number of stars that are in our galaxy. So what makes up all this other material between the stars? Essentially, the stuff that will eventually become stars in the future. Well, if we take a look at it, there's about 12 elements that are the most prominent within the interstellar medium. And of course, of those two, it's hydrogen and helium that makes up almost 100% of the interstellar medium. Now, it depends how we look at it. If we look at it by mass, it's about 75% hydrogen, 25% helium, and about less than 1% of everything else. But if we compare them molecule by molecule, since helium is a much bigger molecule with about four times the mass of hydrogen, you can say that there's about 92% hydrogen and about 7.5-8% helium, and then everything else makes up just a little bit less than 1%. So sometimes you see the different kind of numbers and you wonder, well, what's the right number? So by mass, it's 75-25. By number of molecules, it's roughly 92% versus 8%. Now let's take a look at all the other stuff that is inside the interstellar medium. Of all the other 10 elements, besides hydrogen and helium, oxygen is the most prominent. And so let's say that oxygen is 100%. We're going to compare the abundance of all the other elements just to oxygen. So if we call oxygen 100%, then relative to oxygen, there's about 55% carbon. In other words, for every 100 oxygen molecules, there are 55 carbon molecules. So carbon is the fourth most abundant element in the interstellar medium. After that comes nitrogen. If there's 100 molecules of oxygen, there are 14 molecules of nitrogen. And then for the next one, surprisingly enough, is iron. Of course, when we realize what the reason is why we have supernova explosions, then you realize, yes, iron is a very important element in our universe, but a very special function. So you can see, well, 10% does make sense. But in other words, for every 100 oxygen molecules, there are 10 iron molecules. And there are also 10 silicon molecules. And remember that oxygen mixed with silicon is what makes the crust of the Earth. So these had to be abundant elements when our solar system was formed. Otherwise, the Earth could not have a crust and could not have rocks. The next most abundant element is magnesium, just slightly less than silicon. Then we have sulfur. Then we have aluminum. It's surprisingly, aluminum is also fairly abundant. Then we have calcium. Then we have sodium. Of course, when we talk about abundance, notice when we talk about calcium and sodium, one molecule for every 200 molecules of oxygen. For aluminum, it's about one molecule for every 150 molecules of oxygen. But at least it gives you a good idea about the relative abundance of the various elements that make up the interstellar space and, by and large, the nebulas from which stars are born. And that is how the different consistencies will exist in the various kinds of solar systems and the various kinds of stars. And we'll talk a little bit more about the detail, what makes the difference between a star like the Sun versus another star that doesn't contain many of these heavy elements. So stay tuned, it'll explain some of these things.
What is that gray stuff there? Is it like
stars. Stars as far as the eye can see. It's incredible. I don't know if they can see it through the camera, but if they could see it, it's just an incredible number of stars. It's unimaginable.
Milky Way, right?
Yeah, that's looking towards the center of our Milky Way. It's just incredible.
Right. We're done?
Done for tonight.